您20多岁的时候，您的人生理想是什么样的？
我20岁的时候，我的期望、我的愿望是要成为一个很杰出的律师，赚很多钱。可是，要成为一个律师，当时的新加坡，你必须在英国读书的，成为律师。那我在英国读书，在剑桥3年，在伦敦法律学院1年。我看他管理新加坡是为了他的利益，不是为了我的利益。那我决心跟一部分的同学说，我们回去一定要滚他们出去。所以思想改变了。那怎样要滚他们出去呢？所以我回忆成为一个律师，我有机会代表很多工会，跟政府，
跟殖民政府，
跟殖民政府，跟老板讨论，为了他们的利益，那这样一来，因为我相当有成功了，有成绩了，很多工会就把我成为他们的法律顾问，所以我有一个全体的拥护者，全体人民的拥护者。那以后我要成为律师为了什么？没有意思了，没有意义了。我要的目的是把英国滚出去，把新加坡成为一个在一个第三世界的去建筑一个第一世界的绿国、
绿洲
Oasis。
与改善自然环境同样重要的是建立起一种清新的政治生态。从建国之初起，李光耀和他的伙伴们就下决心要建立廉洁高效的政府。实际上，新加坡政府的廉洁的排名呢，在全球一直是处于前10名，在亚洲呢，处于绝对领先的状态。
And we also have very strict laws. If anybody, any government official or any public servant has property which cannot be explained by a salary, he is presumed to be corrupt. And it is for him to prove that he obtained it without corruption. So that makes it difficult for them. You are corrupt, what for? To enjoy it. Then you have to put it away or put it in your friend's name. And your friend may double cross you. So that makes it very difficult.
1959年6月，李光耀在市政厅大厦会议室宣誓就职新加坡总理的时候，他和政府的其他官员一律身穿白色的衬衫和长裤，象征个人行为纯洁廉明。为了保证政府廉洁，他铁腕治贪，毫不留情，但很多决定的做出对他来说也是非常艰难的。
In your political experience, what was the most painful decision you had to make against corruption?
Well, I had a good minister. He was a great builder of houses. He was an architect. First, he was the head of the housing development board. He built these things.Then I made him a minister for national development. Then after 7-8 years, the Anti-Corruption Bureau, Corruption Investigation Bureau, started investigating him. And their investigations started because he had allowed 2 pieces of land.Be converted for other use. And the man explained to the anti-corruption agency that he had paid $1 million for each of the 2 pieces, or $2 million, which is very small money. He could easily have gone into private practice and made much more. But once the investigation started, he asked to see me. I said, no, if you see me, I'll have to become a witness. I'll see you after the investigations are over. And he committed suicide and left a note.、Mm.
Left a note、yeah. saying what?
He says, I'm an honorable Oriental gentleman.、Mm. I have done wrong. Please forgive me.
After so many years, you still remember this,、yeah. right?
I mean, he could not face his friends, could not face his relatives、mm. because he had broken a serious trust.、Mm.